In this video, we're going to use the Holt method for forecasting. Here we have a case where we're going to handle both the average or the level and the trend. We're going to use this 12 weeks of data, and we're going to use an alpha value of 0.4 and a beta value of 0.1. Okay, to start, we have the step. First step is to set F1 equal to the demand. So we'll do that. Then for the trend number one, we'll set that equal to the A2, actuals 2, minus the actual demand at period 1. Then we can calculate fit at period 2, which is simply the addition of F at period 1 plus T at period 1. Now we can forecast for period 3. First, we have to calculate F2 and T2, and then we'll calculate the fit at period 3. Remember that the fit is the forecast value. F of T is just the smooth average, and T of T is the smooth trend. We need to add those two together to be able to get the forecast, including trend, at the appropriate period. So here we're going to have equal to alpha, which is in cell C1. And we're going to multiply alpha by A2. Then we're going to add 1 minus alpha. Multiplied by F1 plus T1. Now we can calculate T at T. This is going to be equal to beta just in D1 times F2 minus F1 plus 1 minus beta times T1. Now we can calculate fit at period 3, which is just F at period 2 plus T at period 2. That's our forecast. Now we can copy these formulas down. And we can copy the forecast, including trend, down as well, all the way to period 13, where we'll get the next period forecast. Okay, let's graph this. Okay, it's given us a graph, but it's not really what we were looking to do. Let's remove all of what they've done, and we'll do it ourselves. Okay, click Add. First thing we're going to do is to show the demand. The series X values will be the weeks. And then the Y values will be the values in column B for demand. Next, we'll add the forecast, which again is the forecast including trend. We'll use the same X values. And then the Y values. Okay, so let's click OK. Now let's move our chart over a little bit. Now let's change the axes to start at 600. Then what we'll do, we'll move the legend to the right-hand side, and then let's add our axes. Okay, we'll give the one out of the week, and then we'll put the demand forecast. Okay, now let's compute the errors. It's just going to be demand minus forecast, but we can't do it in the first period. And the absolute value of the error. And the mean squared error is going to be, we'll use the sum squared of the errors starting at n5, or go to n5 with the relative reference. Then we're going to divide, in this case, we're always going to subtract 1 from the current week. We don't have the first week. And then the MAD is just going to be the average of the absolute errors. And so we want to put dollar signs on the first one, but not on the second time. Okay, now we'll copy these formulas down. And we'll get a sense of the MAD and the MSE. Here we got a MAD, 59.6 and 6,417.